Welcome to Home Library Book Review Children's Series, where we select a book right from the shelf and explain its content through easy-to-understand text, graphics, examples, and animations, along with discussions with family members. I'm joined with my son, Arnav, to review The Blue Umbrella by Ruskin Bond.
Hey everyone, this book was published in 1980. It is a short, memorable story. It portrays the life of a village girl, and it has a Goodreads rating of more than 4.
Arnav, you must have heard about Himalayas.
Yes, Mom. The Himalayas is a mountain range in Asia.
Absolutely right. And the story unfolds in the hill village of Garhwal at the Himalayas. Let's begin. The story is mainly focused on the little girl Binya, probably 10 years old. She stays with her elder brother Bijju and their mother in the village. They had 3 tiny terrace fields on the side of the mountain where they grew vegetables to live on. Like most mountain girls, Binya was quite sturdy, fair of skin, with pink cheeks and dark eyes and a black hair tied in a pigtail. She wore pretty glass bangles on her wrists and a necklace of glass beads. From the necklace hung a leopard's claw. It was a lucky charm, and Binya always wore it. One day, Binya took both her cows, named Nilu and Gori, on the hilltop. Little far away, she heard some voices, laughter, the clatter of plates and cups. She came upon a party of picnickers. They were holidaymakers from the plains. The women were dressed in bright saris. The men wore light summer shirts. And Binya saw a bright blue umbrella which lay open on the grass besides them. Binya was attracted to the umbrella. The umbrella was like a flower, a great blue flower that had sprung up on the dry brown hillside. Nervously, Binya approached the group. Normally, she would have turned and fled, but the attraction was the pretty blue umbrella. One of the women was attracted to Binya's leopard claw pendant. Binya agreed to exchange her pendant with the blue umbrella. Now, Arnav, you take it over from here.
Yes, Mom. Binya was obsessed with her umbrella. One day, she was crossing the tea shop owned by an old man named Ram Bharosa. Ram Bharosa was astonished to see Binya's blue umbrella. He asked, "Where did you get this? Why don't you sell it to me?" She refused and walked away. One sunny day, Binya sat down in the shade of a pine tree. The umbrella open lay beside her. In some time, she dozed off. While she slept, a wind sprang up. The wind grew stronger. It got into the umbrella and began to drag it over to the rock. The sound of wind woke Binya up. She was on her feet immediately. A fresh gust picked it up and carried it to the very edge of the cliff. The umbrella was stuck on a cherry tree. With great difficulty, she got the umbrella. She noticed that the blue cloth of the umbrella was torn in a couple of places.
Thank you, Arnav. The umbrella was so light, pretty, and blue. Most of the people were envious of Binya's blue umbrella. They knew that if they said nice things about the umbrella, Binya would smile and give it to them to hold for a little while. Just a very little while. Monsoons came up. The umbrella wasn't really a rain umbrella, but it held up bravely. She had been waiting for rain on her umbrella. First, the summer sun, and now the endless rains meant that the umbrella was beginning to fade a little. From a bright blue, it had changed to a light blue, but it was still pretty thin and tougher than it looked, and Ram Bharosa still desired it. He did not want it to sell it, he wanted to own it. The schools were closed during the monsoon. Ram Bharosa had asked Bijju to work in his shop during the holidays, but Bijju did not have time. So Ram Bharosa employed a boy from the next village, a boy called Raja Ram. Ram Bharosa tells Raja Ram that he envies Binya because she refused to sell her umbrella to me. I really like the beautiful umbrella and I want it to be mine. Raja Ram asks Ram Bharosa, "What will you give me if I get the umbrella for you?" Ram Bharosa replies, "Get me the umbrella and I will give you 3 rupees. Binya was in the forest glade where she had first seen the umbrella. No one came there for picnics during the monsoon. The grass was very wet and the pine needles were slipping. The tall trees shut out the light. Binya was in search for porcupine quills.
Mom, what are porcupine quills?
Porcupine quills are large, stiff hairs that help defend them against natural predators. Binya had already found 5 quills and she went ahead to search for more, keeping her umbrella down. Raja Ram had been following Binya for some time. It was his chance to pick up the umbrella now. He waited until Binya had wandered some distance and then running forward, he grabbed the umbrella immediately and dashed off with it. Binya heard his heavy footsteps and turned just in time to see him as he disappeared between the trees. Binya reached the edge of the forest glade in time to see the thief scrambling down the path to the stream. Bijju was coming home from other direction. He saw Binya rushing down the hill and asked, "What's wrong? Why are you running?" Binya paused only to point at the fleeing Raja Ram. "My umbrella," she cried. "He has stolen it." Bijju ran after his sister and said, "I'll catch him soon." He flung himself at the thief, caught him by the legs and brought him down in the water. A tremendous fight took place and Bijju emerged victorious. Raja Ram pleaded, "Let me go. I don't want your useless umbrella. It was Ram Bharosa who told me to get it." The old man, Ram Bharose, suffered the tortures of greed, the despair of loneliness. Because of this, people had stopped coming to his shop. Ever since, it had become known that Ram Bharose had tried to have the wonderful umbrella stolen. The village people had turned against him and started calling him trusty umbrella thief. The old man sat alone in his empty shop, wondering if anyone would ever again step in for a cup of tea. Bijju and Binya passed his shop almost every day. Binya felt bad for Ram Bharose. She kept reasoning with herself, telling herself that the umbrella was her very own and that she couldn't help it if others were jealous of it. But had she loved the umbrella too much? Had it mattered more to her than people mattered? She couldn't help feeling that in a small way, she was the cause of the sad look on Ram Bharose's face. One day, towards end of October, she entered the shop and asked the old man for a toffee. She was Ram Bharose's first customer in almost 2 weeks. Binya took the toffee and left the shop. When Ram Bharose noticed that she has left the umbrella lying on this counter. There it was, the blue umbrella he had always wanted. He stretched out his hand, took the umbrella, pressed it open. He stood beneath it in the dark shadows of his own shop where no sun or rain could ever touch. He thought, I am never in sun or in the rain. Of what use is this umbrella to me? He ran after Binya. He shouted, Binya, Binya, you've left your umbrella behind. But Binya did not take the umbrella. She shook her head and said, you keep it. I don't need it anymore. She said, an umbrella isn't everything. And she left the old man holding the umbrella and went tripping down the road. And there was nothing between her and the bright blue sky. Well, now he has the blue umbrella, a gift from Binya, as he tells everyone. People start visiting his shop again. Next morning, Ram Bharose found a beer claw just outside the door of his shop, and it was his lucky find. He got a locket made of the claw with silver chain and gave it to Binya. And indeed, it looked very beautiful on her. So Arnav, what are the learnings from this story?
So Mom, the learnings from the story are, there is more joy in giving than owning something. Tells us to be kind-hearted. And lastly, be happy with what you have and cherish every part of life.
Thank you for watching our video. Please like and subscribe. Also press on the bell notification button for more videos like these. Until next time, take care and bye.